렘넌트가 만들어야 되는 묵상 운동입니다.
This is the holy meditation movement that our remnants must make.
꼭 기억해야 됩니다.
You must always keep this in your mind.
불신자 왕이 보고 한 얘기입니다.
This is what the unbeliever king said.
정말 여호와의 신에 충만한 자구나.
You are truly the one, one in whom the spirit of the Lord moves.
나는 이런 사람을 처음 봤다.
I've never seen such a person like you.
너를 총리로 세우겠다.
I appoint you as the governor of Egypt.
왕이 한 말입니다.
That's what King Pharaoh said.
렘넌트는 이런 그 망대를 반드시 갖고 있어요.
That is why remnants, you must always have this partisan within you.
사실은 여러분을 파수꾼으로 세운 거예요.
In fact, God has raised you up as a watchman.
이 파수꾼은 망대가 있어요.
As a watchman, you must have this partisan.
이 망대는 그냥 망대가 아니고 움직이는 망대입니다.
It's not just any ordinary partisan. It's a partisan that moves.
그래서 세계화하는 여정을 가는 거예요.
That's why you go on this journey of globalization for world evangelization.
가는 곳곳에 중요한 생명 운동이 일어나야 돼요.
And each and every place you go, important life movement must arise.
이게 이정표입니다.
And this is the guidepost.
이걸 보면서 렘넌트는 이제 선교 발판을 만들고.
As you look at this, remnants, you must make the footstools for missions.
렘넌트의 선교 발판.
And today's message title is Remnants Missions Footstool.
이게 돼서야 이게 발판이 되는 겁니다.
Only when this takes place, and you can have the missions footstool.
그래서 세 가지 꼭 기억해야 돼요.
And that's why you must always remember these three 기준입니다. things. This is our standard.
렘넌트는 237이 되는 게 기준이에요.
Remnants having 237 taking place is your standard.
그 중에 TCK는 5천 종족 살리는 게 기준입니다.
And for TCKs, saving the 5,000 tribes is your standard.
그 중에 전혀 3문화권 반대쪽에 있는 사람도 있어요.
And there are people who are on the opposite end of a third culture.
아예 문화권이 전혀 없는 후대들도 있어요.
And we also have our next generation posterity who have no privilege of any culture whatsoever. That's why I use this term.
그래서 여러분들이 237이 기준인 이유가 뭡니까?
What is the reason that the 237 is your standard?
왜 애굽으로 보냈죠?
Why was he sent to Egypt?
바보라도 눈치채야 돼.
Even if you're a fool, you need to quickly catch on to this.
안 가니까 보냈죠.
Because people wouldn't go to Egypt.
갈 사람이 없어.
And nobody was able to go.
갈 만한 사람을 찾았는데 그게 요셉이에요.
No one was fit enough to go to Egypt, and God found a person who was ready. That was Joseph. That's why God decides to send him to Egypt.
그게 237 나라이기 때문에.
Because there are 237 nations in Egypt.
이게 기준입니다.
That is our standard.
아수르 나라가 왔어요.
And Assyria invaded.
이스라엘 집을 삼킨 거예요.
And invaded Israel.
그래가지고 남자들을 잡아가서 전 세계의 노예 시장에 팔은 겁니다.
They captured all men and sold them off to all the slave market of the world. Why did they do that?
현장으로 보낸 겁니다.
Because they were sent to the field of the 237. You must keep this in your mind.
렘넌트 알면 쉽게 할 수 있습니다.
Remnants, if you know it, then you can easily understand.
그래도 못 알아들어.
Still, people fail to realize.
나라가 바뀌었어.
Now it's a different nation.
아람 나라가 공격하기 시작.
It was now Aram that came to invade Israel.
아람 나라는 아람어를 세계적으로 쓸 수 있을 만큼 세계화된 나라예요.
Aram was a nation that was so globalized that Aramaic, their own language, became the standard language for the whole world.
그래도 못 알아들어.
Still, people fail to realize.
바벨론으로 보냅니다.
They were sent to Babylon.
127 나라를 현재 움직이고 있는 어마어마한 나라를 보낸 겁니다.
They were sent to this mighty nation that was in control over 127 nations.
드디어 로마로.
Ultimately, they were sent to Rome.
여기는 뭐가 있습니까?
What was there in Rome?
모든 길은 로마로.
All roads connect to Rome.
여기다가 복음 간 사람을 보낸 겁니다.
God sent people who had the gospel to Rome.
그래야 세계 흑암을 막을 수 있습니다.
That's how we can block the force of darkness of the world.
여러분의 가치도 잘 모를 뿐만 아니라 복음의 가치를 잘 모르고 있어요.
You fail to realize the value of yourself and also the value of the gospel.
우리나라 탁 떨어지면요, 우리나라 흑암을 전부 없애는 거예요.
If we just have a drip, one drop of the gospel in our nation, all the forms of darkness disappear.
흑암이 무너지는
Not only we have personal salvation taking place, but forms of darkness crumble down. That's why one single missionary is so precious.
그게는 빛이 비치는 거예요.
Because when one single missionary takes the gospel, there is a light that shines forth.
꼭 기억해야 됩니다.
Remnants, you must remember.
그 중에 TCK들은요, 5천 종족 살립니다.
And among the remnants, TCK remnants, you will see 5,000 tribes.
그 일은 반드시 제자가 예비되어 있어요.
Because absolutely, disciples will be prepared.
이번에 오는 인물들 중에 많이 들으실 겁니다.
And I'm sure this time, many remnants who come will have our disciples.
이 제자가 5천 종족의 remnant를 또 살리가 됩니다.
And such disciples will also save and raise remnants among the 5,000 tribes. And what is the key among them?
인재들이 나옵니다.
Gifted and talented individuals.
이게 우리 TCK들이 봐야 될 눈입니다.
This is the eyes vision that our TCK remnants must have.
이 사람들은요, 뭘 알아야 되냐면요.
What about the CCKs and NCKs?
후진국의 병들이 있어요.
That all these underdeveloped countries are all diseased.
아니, 몸 치유해야 됩니다.
They need to have healing of their body.
네, 선진국의 병이 있어요.
And we also see the disease of the developed countries.
다 있지만 주로 이 사람들은 정신적인 병이 많아요.
I'm sure they also have many kinds of diseases, but also mental diseases.
자, 여기에 따라가야 되니까.
Because people need to follow the standard of the developed countries.
중진국의 병이 있어요.
And there are these people of developing countries.
이 사람들은 선진국에 어딘가 붙어야 되기 때문에 사상적인 병이 있어요.
Because they have to attach themselves to the developed countries. The developing countries have the problems of their ideologies.
네, 러시아에 붙어야 되니까 중국에 붙어야 되니까 공산주의라는 걸 하고.
Because North Korea needs to attach itself to Russia. They have this ideology of communism. But Korea, we cannot follow that. That's why we have democracy.
근데 제일 문제가 후진국은 아예 노예가 되는데 중진국이 문제.
So underdeveloped countries, they have all kinds of problems. But developing countries, they need to choose something.
그 혼란이 역사적으로 계속돼.
That we have this such chaos and confusion continuously arising throughout history.
이런 병을 고치려면 remnant를.
In order to heal that disease, it must be the remnant.
기억해야 됩니다.
You must keep this in your mind.
우리 remnant들은 이걸 놓고 질문해야 돼요.
And remnants, knowing this, you need to ask this question.
이때 나를
Why God has called me in such a time as this? You need to seek this out.
그러면 세 가지가 나올 겁니다.
Then three things will come out.
왜 이 교회 나를 부르실까?
Why did God call me to this church?
왜 이 교회 하나님 나를 부르실까?
Although this church might be very small, why did God call me to this church? Then you can find three things.
당연성.
Rightfulness.
하나님이 나를 필요로 하신 겁니다.
It is because God needs me.
필연성.
It is necessity.
하나님의 절대 계획이 있는 겁니다.
It's because there is God's absolute plan.
절대성.
It is absoluteness.
세 가지를 깨달아야 돼요.
You need to realize three things.
당연성.
Rightfulness.
하나님이 우리 부모님을 이 동네 보내서 할 수 없이 나는 여기 와서
God sent my parents to this region. That's why I had no choice but to go to this church here.
하나님 부모님이 미국에 이민을 가서 할 수 없이 난 거 태어난 거예요.
Because my parents immigrated to America, I had no choice but to be born in America. Rightfulness.
그러나 두 가지 중에 왜 나를?
However, you need to ask why me? For what?
절대성.
Absoluteness.
렘넌트는 꼭 이렇게 찾아야 됩니다.
Remnants. This is how you must seek these out.
렘넌트 통해서 일어날 일은 무궁무진하기 때문에 여러분들이 여러분 생각에 갇히지 말고. 기도 계속하셔야 됩니다.
It is infinite that the works will arise through our remnants. That's why do not be
기도하겠습니다.
engulfed by your own thinking.
감사드립니다.
Let us pray. Father God, we thank you.
앞으로 일어날 하나님의 생명의 역사에 동참하게 하심을 감사합니다.
Thank you so much for allowing us to partake in your ministry of life movement.
오늘 이 모임과 기도가 역사적인 시간이 되게 해 주옵소서.
May this gathering and may this be this the time of your historic work.
이름으로 기도하옵나이다.
In our Lord Jesus Christ, and we pray, Amen.